Becky Stacey, I'm a technology teacher at McKeel Academy of Technology, and so we decided to build Sea Perch ROVs, remote operated vehicles. They came as a kit, and it was basically some uncut PVC pipe with electronic components just in plastic bags, circuit board, motors, and things, and the students had to completely put them together. Including soldering the components onto the circuit board, waterproofing the motors, mounting the thrusters and all of that. So it was a great project for the spring, and then we culminated by coming to the pool to test them.
We added weights because the buoyancy of the noodles made it go up too far, so we had to add weights to counteract the noodles, so that it could stay buoyant and go down. It took us about a week or so to get all of it together because there was a lot of intricate parts, such as drilling holes in the right spots and attaching the motors with wax and water sealing everything.
This program was actually started by the Office of Naval Research. It's called SeaPerch, and the idea was to get students familiarized with an underwater drone assembly. So this one is actually a national competition, and here at McKeel we're just starting out for the first year experimenting with it. It was a great opportunity for the students to experience a different aspect of robotics. Anytime you can get the students with hands-on learning, this experiential option of being able to learn what they're doing through action is fantastic. You know, they're able to go through some iterations in the pool where they're testing out, is their robot neutrally buoyant? What are some factors leading to it? And being able to test out whether their assembly of the thrusters and their PVC structure actually worked. So it was great. Anytime you can get the students actively engaged is a good opportunity.